Hello everyone, and welcome back to another installment of Let's Play Ark the Lad Twilight of the Spirits. You know how I said the last episode was going to be a short one? Yeah, I could not have been more wrong if I tried. I apparently forgot how long the cutscenes were before we began the story of our second protagonist. With that out of the way, let's continue on my pointless quest to get my senpai's Chugga Conroy and Vlarg Skeletor to, or also known as Fine Sauce Joel, to notice me. Much like the beloved Joel Johansson, we ourselves have a frog-like parental figure. Except she's universally hated, unlike Kermit the Frog. What are you doing? What are you doing? Go over to Orkoth on the double and buy me some phoenix blood. I get really nasty when I run out of that stuff. That was my attempt at doing a Kermit the Frog impression. I apologize if I made anyone's ears bleed. I'm just gonna say from the start, I am not a fan of Dark's voice. I mean, compared to Karg, who you could enjoy hearing talk, Dark, not so much. It sounds like gravelly generic Monster of the Week from a superhero show voice. It just doesn't sound very main character-y. But one of the things I love about this game is that none of the characters are perfect. Almost like people. The flaws they have, I mean. And as you can see, there's a bit of a difficulty. He's Spike here. We're starting this out all alone. And while we have access to magic, we're probably gonna have to focus on using healing spells on ourselves.
What was that?
Let's get a good position to kill this mushroom.
How's that? You'll regret that. Which path should I walk?
Yeah, I mean, you hear those lines coming from Dark, and it's just... it just sounds a little too Christian Bale-y. I'm more of a Kevin Conroy man myself.
die!
Oh, real nice. Get over the shiny so I can't get them.
That all you got?
You twisted fiend. Actually, if we can attack the tree trunk, let's do it. And of course, Wonder isn't going to do it.
Must I fight? What was that?
Okay, now we know not to attack that tree trunk because it's completely pointless. Come on. There we go.
You'll regret that. Can I use this?
In a sense, you can use it. You can use the gold for goods and services, and the spirit stones to replenish your mana.
Too slow.
I want the blue shiny it's got up there, so I'm gonna have to wait. Oh joy.
Must I fight?
If you want to live. As the old adage goes, you want peace, prepare for war. I don't remember who said that.
Can I use this? Die! Say ya! This doesn't look good. Done yet. My power increases.
Oh, nice.
Fool. The Deimos only understand power. If I just had more power.
than sorry.
Strange one. This should be fun, eh?
She's probably jealous she can't have wings and fly. Which, to be fair, would be pretty cool. Although walking in through doorways would be a hassle. And hallways. Have to start walking in on an angle. Apparently what I have to do to talk to this NPC. Come on. Come on, Greg DeepOrcon. Too soon. Seems we weren't going to be stuck with Greg for a while. Tell me more. what do you know? No, they're not actually there. Also, a creature that is obsessed with only making money? Sounds like your typical Wall Street person. Hey-o! Of course, you're not going to let me talk to him. It's never that simple. Is it delay in input commands? Confound it. Always off by a second. Then explain the plot point we were just given. Not a half bad place to live. In what appears to be an abandoned subway station. That was a roar. Thank you. as you could see from that little cutscene, this just seems like a nice little place to live, doesn't it? Anyways, I'm gonna stop the video at this point because we are nearing the 25-minute mark, so, I'm UltraGamerJ. I hope to see you all in the next video, and please remember to like and subscribe for more content.